The Obamacare insurance marketplaces are failing to sign up uninsured Americans. That's the finding from two new surveys. The Washington Post reports one survey shows only 10% of uninsured Americans have signed up, and nearly 90% of those who bought insurance on the Obamacare exchanges said they were just switching from an existing plan. The Obamacare online process does not allow applicants to say whether they're uninsured. March 31st is the deadline to sign up for insurance, but the Obama administration keeps rewriting the rules to delay political fallout until after the fall elections. This week, they decided people can keep their insurance plans even if they don't meet the requirements of the law. Well, for more on this now, we turn to Ken Blackwell with the Family Research Council. Thanks for joining us, Ken.
Lori, good to be with you.
Well, the president announced insurers can keep customers on policies that don't comply with Obamacare for two more years. What do you think is behind that move?
Every day, more and more people are finding out that Obamacare is unworkable, unaffordable, and it is falling out of favor with anyone who's tried to work his or her way through the system. And so what we see now is the Obama administration ratcheting up their political gear to make sure that they can retrofit the Obamacare implementation schedule in a way that coincides with a favorable outcome for them, meaning the Democrats on the political side, on the political schedule. So this is just an effort to delay consumer malcontent, discontent with Obamacare past the next election cycle.
Well, do you think that the American voters will be fooled by this tactic come November?
Oh, absolutely not. The horror stories that we're hearing are not something that's made up by the opposition party. It's not something that's made up by conservatives. More and more Democrats, moderates, liberals are finding that it just doesn't work. And young people are starting to more and more hold their noses to a health care plan that's geared to take over 1/5 or 1/6 of our economy, depending on your calculation, and radically and fundamentally transform the world's best health care system that needs some fine tuning but doesn't need radical transformation.
Well, supposedly the goal was to offer affordable insurance to the uninsured, but now we find out only about 10% of uninsured Americans have signed up. Why do you think that's so?
Well, uninsured Americans didn't leave their brains, at their front door. They can do the math. They know that it's not working. They know that, you know, Obamacare has been filled with broken promises. The leading promise is that you can keep your doctor if you want to. Well, that hasn't happened. This is a mess. And it's a mess that I tend to believe is a deliberate calculation to create such a mess of things that the only solution, only timely solution, would be to move to a one-payer system or a government-controlled system, which just won't work.
All right, Ken Blackwell, thanks so much for joining us today.
Good to be with you.